Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. With the introduction in English and the atmosphere of research, to talk on Sab Sath Dengi, it is something like going to Srinathji temple and getting a prasada of chicken pulao. So, I will talk in English and the topic will be translation of this Sab Sath Dengi. This is neither Hindi nor English. It could be a Hindi spoken by a Keralite in Bombay, which means we all grow together. In Bhagavad Gita, third chapter, Bhagavan Sri Krishna brings out the whole theme in a most wonderful manner, where he says, Sahayajna praja srishtva purovacha prajapatihi anena prasavishchadvam eshavos trishtakamaduk. He says, when the God created this world, that time he also created a spirit of action. There are two things. One is action and second is the spirit behind action. If the action is an expression of bitterness, if action is an expression of frustration, burden, those actions are a destructive force. And when the actions are the expression of joy or happiness, when the actions are an expression of celebration of life, then those actions are a very constructive force. In both the cases, whether you are destructive or constructive, togetherness is required. And therefore, let us try to see this spirit. Sahayajna praja srishtva. So having created this world, along with the spirit, and the spirit is technically termed as yajna. This is the beauty of Bhagavad Gita, where the old traditional words from the Vedas are reinterpreted in the modern context as required. Like we do. The other day I received one SMS. Why Lord Shiva and Parvati could not learn computers? So I replied back, I don't know. Reply came back, because Ganesh ji took away the mouse. Now this word mouse is used in the English language with a different meaning and in the computer science with a different meaning. In the same manner, this word yajna is used in the traditional Vedic literature with a different understanding and flavor, but the same word is used in the Bhagavad Gita to bring out a different meaning, different texture. In the Vedic understanding, what is before our eyes when we hear the word yajna? There is a hole made in the soil, and then there is little bit of construction out of some bricks, and in that hole you go on putting a lot of fuel and burn the things and then go on adding various things in the name of the Lord. And then from that Yajna Kunda, somebody called as Yajna Purusha is born. And that Yajna Purusha, he gives something as the gift. And that gift is used by the one who performs the Yajna for whatever he has invoked. Now to understand this principle, you all must have seen the Ramayana serial. There we come across when Dasharathji didn't have any putra. So he conducted a yajna called as Putra Kameshti Yajna. Putra Kameshti Yajna means, why there is no son, there is a mistake. Ka mistake. So Putra Kameshti Yajna. Therefore they did a yajna to remove that mistake. It is a research center, isn't it? And a particular priest was called, he did the yajna, and from that yajna, one person came out with a pot of kheer, milk. And then that was given to his queens and the children were born. So whenever we talk of yajna, in the context of the Vedic literature, this picture comes in front of us. Now also you must be seeing many places, 108 Kundiyam Mahagayatri Yajna is being performed like that. So this is one way. Now in the present context, what we have to understand? What is the meaning of Yajna? See, I was discussing with your director just now about what you do in this institution. So I was told that you are conducting some research, producing some medicines. So, we are discussing. I said, are you taking some hints from Ayurveda? And then, Ayurvedic medicine, there are less side toxic effects. And in your allopathic chemically compounded medicine, there are more toxic effects. So, what could be the reason? We are discussing. My understanding about Ayurveda is totally different than all of you. My understanding is like this. Ayurvedic medicine is given to the patient for any disease, and that medicine is so bitter to avoid to take it next time the patient says, I am cured. This is the technique. At least I do like that. Because you will never see any Ayurvedic medicine with any taste. It is so bitter. It brings out not only your intestines, but even the disease gets out because of the bitterness. So I was told that in the Ayurvedic medicine, from the plants in the natural state, there are many, many components in different permutation and combination, and they together help in the curing of a particular ailment. But this does not happen when we chemically extract the alkaloid or whatever medicine and then compound it and give as a strong dose. This doesn't happen. What it means? It means the power of working together in a symbiotic manner is more creative than the power of isolated, separate action. And this is what is called as the spirit of Yajna. In the spirit of Yajna, the teacher says, he said, Purovacha Prajapatihi, the Lord, after having created the world, he said, what he said? If you follow the spirit of Yajna, meaning spirit of working together for a common good, to go into our assistance, then only we are able to achieve or do something. Like here we are all together. See how many factors have gone together. And then only we are here and some transaction of knowledge is taking place. Therefore, if somebody thinks, suppose I think, I alone can give knowledge, and then you all refuse to come. When I came over here, I was sitting backside. Do you know why? Other than me and the chairs, there was nobody here. So, we were discussing, I think the people will come on time. Nobody comes here before time. It is only the speakers who come because it is their need to talk. So we were sitting there. I said, hey, you have constructed a very beautiful bridge. Only we have to request a river to flow below that. Isn't it? So after you have come together, then only I can talk. Meaning, I alone in your absence cannot talk. So in this transaction of knowledge, we together are required. In the same manner, anything that we do or achieve in our life, the first principle to be recognized is a spirit of togetherness is a strong force. Now the second step. The Lord says, Anena prasavishadvam eshavaha astu ishtakamadhuk. Now by the spirit of working together for a common goal, you shall attain prosperity. Now see, if we really want to achieve prosperity, we all have to work together. And when we work together, we have to forget or drop our individual idiosyncrasies. If we are unable to do that, we cannot work in a spirit of togetherness. So, anena prasavishadvam, if you follow this principle in your life, then you shall certainly attain material prosperity. Because esha astu ishtakamadhuk, because this spirit, this philosophy behind action is like the desire fulfilling cow. You know, in our mythology, there is a story about this Kamadhenu. Kamadhenu is desire fulfilling cow. The story comes like this. Vashishta, the great sage, had this Kamadhenu. And that time, Vishwamitra was a king. And he came. He said, why Swami requires this thing? Hey Babaji, a king should have it. So give it to me. So Vashishthi said, no, nothing doing. It is mine, it will remain with me. Is it? And then Vishwamitra comes and attacks to take away the cow. Vashishthaji takes the cow, produce the army and finish this fellow. Now that cow produces army. And this Vishwamitra is defeated. So, Ishtakamadhuk, that cow which has a capacity to yield anything in life. And what is that Kamadhuk? What is that Kamadhenu? What is that desire fulfilling cow? It is the spirit of together, working for a common goal, keeping in view the welfare of all. See, now all these things are put together in a formula, like you have got Zn plus H2SO4 is equal to H2SO4 plus H2O, whatever it is, ZnSO4H2O. So this is a formula. It is not only alphabets written. In the same manner, Kamadhuk is a technical word which includes so much of information into one word. So when we take this spirit of living together, working together, and when we have to live together, work together, what we have to do? We have to forget our individual differences. And when we forget our individual differences, then only the best in us can surface. And then only we can really achieve success, prosperity in our life. But you know, this is a boon or a tradition or a culture that we have in India. Once I went for one's school's exhibition and they were showing some different kinds of specimens of animals. Zoological exhibition of a school. And so many like earthworms and all kinds of things. So there was one section where there were crabs. So there were about half a dozen crab jars covered. First Indonesian crabs, then Japanese crabs, then Korean crabs, Sri Lankan crabs. And everything was covered with a petri dish and tied down. And there was one container having the Indian crabs, but there was no cover. So out of my own foolishness, I told, I said, hey, probably you have forgotten to cover it. All these fellows will go away. So that student could not understand. Oh, okay, Swamiji, we'll put. Then after we went little ahead, the teacher came and told me, Swamiji, this doesn't happen. So why? They said they are Indian crabs. So discipline? No. Then when one is trying to go up, the other pulls him down. So they all remain together. See? So when we are living in a spirit of togetherness, what is required is we bring out our best. Second, we are not jealous about others. And third, we are able to contribute for the common cause. See? And if this is understood and if this is remembered, sky is the limit for our progress. But like we see in our country, we have got two parties. One, ruining party, and second is opposition party. Not ruining, ruling, I am sorry. So, there is one ruling party and second is the opposition party. Now, what is their function? Their function is, whatever the ruling party says must be opposed, because I am opposition. So, the ruling party says, let us do this thing that we will have the globalization and therefore we will put this bill in the parliament. Opposition, no. We will not go in for globalization, only for our trade or various production. Then we should go for globalization even at the level of corruption. Ah, then it is okay. See. Therefore, friends, the spirit of togetherness with a common goal of achieving something creative has to be accepted by every one of us as the only way to progress. I was reading one old magazine. In late 1930s, before the clouds of the Second World War began gathering together, 1938 or so, there was a thought floating that if now present Gujarat, that time there was no present Gujarat, Gujarat and Maharashtra, if these two areas come together and make an independent country, they will outwit even any European country. That time Japan was nowhere. So when this was said, I read it, I started thinking about it. I said, hey, what could be the reason why those people, whosoever has written this in 1938, what could be the reason? Then I started working on that. And I discovered the following thing. You will see, Dr. Kurien has been the father of white revolution only because he was in Gujarat. I guarantee he will definitely fail the moment he will go in Kerala. He is a Keralite. See. Now what is the reason? The reason is the people of Gujarat or Maharashtra, they have that culture, that tradition, that working together. That is why the cooperative movements are successful only in these two states, nowhere else. Therefore, friends, the spirit of togetherness is such a strong force. And in that, what we have to do is contribute our might and delete our individuality, the ego. And when this becomes the spirit behind action, any undertaking has to be successful. Now, for that, the teacher continues further. What exactly happens when we work in a spirit of togetherness, Sab Sath Dengi? What happens? Lord Sri Krishna says,
देवान् भावयतानेन ते देवा भावयन्तुः परस्परं भावयन्तः श्रेय परमवाप्सथ. He says, when we work together in a spirit of togetherness for a common goal, we invoke a strength of togetherness called technically as Deva, gods. See, in our scriptures, the life is expressed at three levels. See how deep is the understanding. One is called as material existence. Second is called as functional existence. And third is called as subjective existence. Three. Like if you take the sun in the sky. The sun in the sky that we see hanging in the space is the material existence of power. So that sun is giving us light and energy. Then there is the second sun called as the functional sun. Now that functional sun is that one which appears in the stories of our Puranas. Like the stories go that when there was this Samudra Manthan and ambrosia or the nectar came out and the devas and the asuras, they were together. Now the asuras means those bad people, they wanted to consume all the nectar. So the Lord took avatar of Mohini and then he was befooling them and he was giving that nectar only to the gods. And in between the gods line, this Rahu came and sat. And when the ambrosia or the nectar was given to this daitya, this rakshasa, Rahu, that time sun and the moon, both were sitting both sides, they told the Lord, he is not God, he is a rakshasa. Is it immediately that Mohini Bhagwan cuts the throat of that Rahu, and therefore Rahu is only head without the remaining body, and Ketu is only the body without the head. So naturally when he took that ambrosia nectar, immediately it came out and he could not become immortal. Now this is the story. And because of this, this Rahu is always angry with the sun and the moon. And therefore every now and then the Rahu goes and eats away the sun. So when the Rahu eats the sun, there is an eclipse. And thank God there is nothing beyond the throat. So again the sun comes out and eclipse is over. Now this sun god, this moon god, this sun god because of whom this Kunti was blessed with Karna, this is called as the functional existence. And there is a third existence called as the subjective existence. We are all having structural eyes plus functional eyes. Somebody may have beautiful eyes, Meenakshi, but cannot see anything. So what is the use of that Meenakshi who cannot see? Because there is no vision. So this functional subjective eye is called as the subjective existence. Now bring all these things together. Sun is the general light illuminating the world. Therefore, we can see the world only in the light of the sun or any external light. Second thing, we are able to see the colors and forms only when our functional eyes are normal. So it is said that the sun lord who is functioning through the sun in the sky and the sun lord functioning through the eyes is one and the same. And therefore eyes can only see colors and forms, they cannot smell, they cannot taste, they cannot touch. Thus in this whole creation, this is the three-tier existence. One is the subjective existence, second is the objective existence, and third is the functional existence. This functional existence has to live in cooperation mutually with each other.
then only we can bring out the best. Therefore, when the teacher says, Devan bhavayatanena, te deva bhavayantu vaha, when we invoke this functional ability of all the people together in a creative manner, what will happen? The strength of togetherness will surpass all the obstacles of individuality. See, one day, in one of my camps in Himalayas, there were some girls who came from Korea. For the first time I met them, I never seen, known who are they. And our camp, meditation camp was going on. Second or third day, they become little bit open up. And one girl asked me this question. Swamiji, I really am enjoying the whole camp, your beautiful country. But I have got one observation. What is the observation? She said, how beautiful observation, she said. She said, Korea is a rich country, but Koreans are poor. And India, Indians are rich, but India is a poor country. See, what a beautiful observation. Here we think about how much I get. And there they think about how much our nation is working for. So whenever in our spirit of thinking behind action, if we are having real concern about the totality, then only the spirit of togetherness becomes a blessing. Otherwise, it becomes only a selfishness. So I am concerned only about my prosperity, even at the cost of others. Therefore, Devan bhavayatanena te deva bhavayantuvaha. When we invoke the spirit of togetherness, we will be mutually helping each other. And in this manner, parasparam bhavayantaha. That is real prosperity where everyone is prosperous together. Otherwise, if my prosperity is by killing you, it is not prosperity. So, after having given the importance of the spirit of togetherness, now the next step. Life is that where consumable goods are available in plenty. You know, the other day I was coming from Australia to India. And with somebody I was staying, so I said, hey, I'll be meeting your people in Bombay. If you want to send some gift, you can give it to me, I'll carry and give it to them. No, Swamiji, we don't want to send anything. I said, why? Last time, what happened, you know? I carried one gift for my people there. And when I carried the gift, I thought they'll be very happy to receive the gift, foreign gift. So when I gave something, they say, oh, it's very nice, keep down. They were never excited about it. And after some time, one of the child came and told, Uncle, this you brought me, it's very good. But you know, this is available, see, on that road in front of our house, on that footpath, this is available for 5 rupees. Now this fellow who got a gift from Australia to give to his children or a relation, he was feeling so disgusted because in earlier days nothing was allowed to be made available. And therefore, even if you get a toothbrush from other country, it was a great deal. See, the moment you get into the openness of business, you are bound to prosper. But instead of thinking prosperity at the global age, we still go on, some of us, go on hanging about the small little koopa manduka vritti. It cannot help. The other day, some people, when I went for a talk, they advised me. People advise us more than listening to us. They said, Swamiji, when you are giving a talk, kindly in your talk mention that we are Indians, be Indian, buy Indian. I said, I'll talk whatever I want to talk. I'll not talk what you want to talk, then you go and talk, I'll listen. He said, no, when you talk, it makes a difference. I said, okay, then I'll talk different. Then I mentioned in my talk, look here, when I am spending, let us take 10 lakh of rupees for buying a car, I should be patriotic in buying the Indian goods. But is it not equally important for the Indian producers that they should be equally patriotic so that their goods are comparable with the international market? Why should I spend my money on patriotism? See, it is not a one-way business. You know, in the earlier days, there used to be advertisement about our ambassador car. Ambassador car is that car whose every part makes noise when it runs, except the horn. Isn't it? And then we are supposed to buy that car. Why? Because it is patriotism. No, it is not. So once you are in the open global market, now you have destroyed and transcended all the limitations of this small little thinking. Today, in today's world, we have to think on an economic front. See? He whosoever is economically strong is right. See, in our old Sanskrit literature, it is said, Sarve guna kanchanam ashrayanti. A rich person is a great dharmatma. A rich person is always right. A rich person's stupidity is wisdom. The ugliness of a rich person is beauty. Because it is the wealth that counts. In today's world, if economic strength is the real strength, it cannot come when you shut your doors to the whole world. And if you have to open the doors to the whole world, you have to be competitive. And competitiveness comes only when you have got quality of people. See? And when this is brought together, all the quality people based on their abilities, and not on the debilities. See? But when we try to help people, how we want to help the people? Bringing 4 polio affected, useless children together to lift an elephant. It can never happen. Therefore, we have to recognize the quality of a person. Now this is what the teacher says, that if we really want to bring up our nation, we have to give up the old ways. You know what happens in today's world, in India, everywhere, very much agitations are going on. Why these agitations are going on? It's only on this. Quality is not respected. Everything else other than the quality is important. See? And that is why when Bhagavad Gita tells us that if we really want to have a prosperous life, annat bhavanti bhutani parjanyat anna sambhavaha. Anna means the products which are available for consumption. You cannot eat the dry rice, you have to cook it, convert the raw material into consumable goods. So if we want to convert the raw material into consumable goods, you require quality people. See, like in your center, research and R&D center, you can't appoint somebody because somebody is somebody something. No, he must know the subject very well. He should have the ability to understand and go beyond the frontiers of knowledge. Our mind can entertain only the area of known field. Our mind cannot go beyond the domain of knowledge. to peep beyond the domain of knowledge is called as research. And for that, we don't require emotional people. We require intelligent people. Because intelligence has the capacity to break the barrier of the limits of knowledge and conquer the new areas of wisdom. Therefore, when you want to appreciate somebody, how do we appreciate? We appreciate, is this one is very intelligent. Because intelligence is not somebody else's private property. Therefore, friends, when the teacher says, Annat Bhavanti Bhutani Parjanyat Anna Sambhavaha, and how this prosperity, the life throbs with real joy, when there is parjanya. Parjanya means the spirit of working without selfishness and without any biasness. When this happens, then alone life prospers. And when we have to do this, we have to keep in view the most important principle, that all the prosperity, now this is the second topic, very important, please understand. Material prosperity without the foundation of the spiritual backdrop leads to mental perversion. Please understand this. Yesterday I had a talk in Maninagar. A very huge crowd, about 700-800 people, all giggling, laughing. It was in Hindi. And after my lecture was over, I came down. One young boy with a helmet in the hand and came, Swamiji, I got a question. I said, who cares? You have, keep it with you, I don't know. No, please tell me. What is that? He started a very rough language. I'll tell you his own words. Swamiji, I like sex. So what do I do? Is it necessary that you should not have sex with anybody except with your wife? I said, you finish first all your sex out of your heart, then I'll talk to you. He said, I enjoy. Is it not remaining in joy is spirituality? So, if I go on enjoying everywhere, whatever way I want, what is wrong if I am doing that way? I am still spiritual. Is it not? I said, whenever you have doubt, you are not convinced of it. If you are convinced, like, do you come and insist? Do you know? I am a man. Every now and then. Do you know? I am a man. Then people will start suspecting. Why this fellow is telling every time, I am a man. We have never objected. We have never thought about anything. But this fellow every now and comes, do you know I am a man? Look, I got a beard. I am a man. I said, in the same manner, when you are insisting again and again, whether this is right or wrong, you are having a doubt in your mind. If you have doubt, your conscience is not accepting it. You are cheating yourself. Yet he was unable to digest this, insisting. I said, look here, let us take it this way. If you want to enjoy, enjoy, let me go. So everything is over. That means you accept that my way of thinking about sex is spirituality. I said, I did not say that. Don't put those words in my mouth. He said, actually, Swamiji, I wanted to ask this thing, but I can't ask my mom and dad, therefore I am asking you. I said, now you have brought mother and father, now I'll talk to you. Just for your understanding. I said, look here, suppose I call you a bastard. Will you like it? No. But this is not an abuse in the Western world. Because they don't have some institution called as father. See, if you go to US, you will see in their medical departments, when a lady delivers a baby, There is only the child's name and mother's name. There is no column for father's name. Because there is nothing like father. ये तो भगवान की दया से हो जाता है. And therefore, if you call them as bastard, it is not an abuse, it is a noun. As long as you are living in our country and you feel insulted if I call you bastard, till then you are not convinced that what you are doing is wrong. Therefore, friends, whenever we talk of living together and prosperity, it is all true, it is all required. But our country stands for the spiritual strength. 2010, they are going to have the Commonwealth, isn't it? In India. This time for the Commonwealth in Melbourne, I was there for all the 6-7 days. And everywhere, throughout Australia, everywhere, even in various airports or Singapore, Malaysia, everywhere, big, big hoardings. Incredible India. And what is incredible India? Honda or Toyota? Incredible India. Yoga, meditation, japa. See? The whole world recognizes India as a spiritual hub. See? So when the teacher says, work together, attain material prosperity, that does not mean get away like animalistic lifestyle. We have to have the foundation of spiritual life. And therefore, spirituality means that wherein our attention is on the divine principle. And if our attention is on divine principle, the first thing that happens is, if I have discovered divinity in me, I will see divinity in you. This is a simple rule. If my attention is on my wealth, how will I classify the world? In this world, there are two types of people, poor and rich. If my attention is only at the body level, what I will look at the world? This world has two kinds of people, male and female. If my attention is only on the human beings, what I will say? In this world, there are two types of beings. One are human beings and other mammals. If my attention is on my emotions, then I will look at the world. This world has two people, emotionally balanced people and emotionally wrecks. If my attention is on intellect, I will say, this world is consisting of two people. One, intelligent like me and dumb like others. See? Now go further. If my understanding is, spirituality means a brand. See? Then those who are of my brand, they are spiritual. Those who do not accept my brand, they are to be killed. Think. But if we understand spirituality means, be very attentive, that common, undivided, conscious, blissful existence supporting all the differences and yet not getting differentiated, that is the absolute reality. And if that reality is discovered to be my essential nature, I cannot see ugliness and horrible thing in others. There is a saying in Sanskrit, papi sarvatra papam ashankate. A person with
a sinful disposition, sees only sins everywhere. See? Therefore, friends, all our material prosperity, living together, etc., is essential part of our life. But that does not mean we should divorce from the foundation of spiritual existence. When this is not understood, what we see today in the whole world under the name of the religion, the most ugly things happen. Therefore, this material prosperity, if it is divorced from the spirituality, it leads to mental perversion. Mental perversion is not what is meant by living together in a spirit of togetherness. Therefore, as we are all living in our life, whatever business you are in, whatever work you are doing, do that to the best of your ability, keeping in view the goal that is set. That is one part of your life. The second part is, we have to take care of our spiritual hunger. See, you are all educated here in the research field. Unless you have studied, prepared yourself well during your school, college days, you cannot be admitted in this department. It is not an accident, it is an achievement. In the same manner, now during this period of your life, unless you prepare for your retired life, life will become hell. We come across many elderly people. Depression, frustration. Today somebody met me, I went to house, somebody's house, and that old lady, she has gone in depression. So, Swamiji, can you please help her coming out of depression? I said, look here, I have not pushed her into depression, so how can I take her out? No, what can we do? We can do nothing unless she wants. Be very attentive. In our old life, old days, one of the most important problem everybody faces is a sense of unwantedness and a sense of loneliness. Recently, I have seen one documentary when I was in Australia on depression, 1 hour documentary. And in that, they started, one of the governors from one of the states of Australia, he has resigned from that job. He is such a top official in the government machinery. Governor is not an ordinary thing in that country. I am not talking about India. So, he resigned the job on the basis that I am depressed. I will not be able to do justice to my job. So, here I have resigned. And naturally, it became a big news. So, when I was there, somebody told me, Swamiji, can these things happen in India? I said, no, in India it is the other way around. What is that? Because of these politicians, the citizens get depressed. They are happy. Nothing happens to them. They are perfectly all right. So, what is the reason of depression? The reason of depression is, they have analyzed in a very big way, that when you suddenly come to realize and recognize that you are an unwanted attic piece in the house. Suddenly, as if the carpet is pulled away below your feet. Because when you grow, your children are growing, your wife is there, your husband is there, everybody wants each other. Then your children are in class 10, then they go in college. As they start going in college and all that, there is already a vacuum at home. Then only, hum do aur hamari jhagda, nothing else. Then slowly, slowly, that starts becoming a big problem. And then, hold on to each other,
And then the old stories, this happened, that happened, and jhagda and frustration. And out of these two, like in any cricket match, both the batsmen are never out simultaneously, one at a time. So if the husband is out first, only wife is remaining, she is able to negotiate through the turmoils of life after the husband dies comfortably and with courage. But if it is the other way around, if the wife is smart and she goes away, and then this Bhole Baba is left behind. For him, everything, where is my hanky? It is there. He is sitting only like Ganapati. Then, where are my socks? They are in your hand. For every small little thing, dependence, dependence, dependence. Now that wife has gone. Now, everything, you know. Take the toothbrush in the hand. Paste kaha hai? Sensitive, frustrated. Nobody to talk. Marna hi accha hai. And such people don't die also. And then they make their life miserable, they make the lives of others miserable, and then such patients come to us. Swamiji, can you please advise me what happened, you know, after my wife died? I am feeling so lonely. What I should do? I said, get married again. There was one young husband and wife, and the wife asked the husband that, honey, if I die, husband said, hey, don't talk that, I'll get mad, I can't imagine that. No, suppose I die, I told you I'll get mad, don't say that. Then the wife becomes angry. Now listen to me what I'm telling, let me complete. Yes. Suppose I die, will you get married again? The husband says, I won't get that mad. See, therefore friends, we have to have this balance. Work together in your field where you earn money, your bread, your name, your fame, your achievements, your discovery, this is all required. Do that sincerely. At the same time, do not neglect the spiritual component of your life. That is very, very important. Because we are all, whether we want or not, we are all Indians, whatever religion you may belong. Our stuff is made of spirituality. See? For the first time in 80s, when I went to US for the first time, I just wanted to have the experience of that country, what it is like. So I thought, let me go as a volunteer and do some job. So I registered myself as a volunteer and went in a hospital just to sit with a patient. There everything is, you know, official and all rules and regulations. So I went there. When I reported, they say you have to go to patient number so and so and listen to her, whatever she says. So she gets a company. Because there they don't get company. So I went and sat. And I said, Amma, how are you? Now my default setting. So every lady I call Amma. So Amma, how are you? She looked at me. I am not your mother. So I withdrew my word. I'm so sorry. I'm called by everybody as Maggie. So in my mind I said, 2 minutes, noodles. So I sat quiet. Then I said, yes, what can I do for you? Yes, you are a volunteer today? I said, yes. Sit down. So I sat down. And she started talking about her dogs. Not one, not two. She had number of dogs. And like we have got Ramayana, like Dogayana. Different. I had this dog and it happened and he died and then this thing, that thing, you know. And before I came over here, I had a beautiful bulldog. Bulldogs are never beautiful. But I had a beautiful bulldog and then, you know, when there was nobody to look after and I was feeling so bad and poor darling was feeling very lonely without me. Because he has never slept alone. See the prosperity. When you don't get a human being to sleep with, you compromise with a dog. Because you have no God. See. Therefore, when I was coming to the hospital, then I was thinking, now what this poor fellow will do? So, I administered euthanasia and put him to sleep. At least, you know, he'll be happy. See the thinking. And after that 45 minutes torture about dog, I got up and went out. Then at the counter I had to tell. So he said, how did you like the patient? I said, wow, wow, wow. Because 45 minutes I was listening only about dogs, nothing else. Now tell me, in the old age, when you are in the hospital, normally in our country we think about God, is it not? Bhagwan ka naam lo, Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. But there is no spiritual strength at all. Therefore, friends, please remember, life is incomplete without introduce an element of spirituality in your life. And the element of spirituality is not external. Full stop or U-turn, isn't it? Or an exclamation or Rudraksha Mala, Tulasi Mala or Vaijanti Mala. It's not going to help. We have to spend, be very attentive, every day, 1 hour with ourselves. That time, try to practice that you are Mr. Nobody. This is all. Wherever you are sitting, doesn't matter. Only this is the practice. You are Mr. Nobody. I guarantee you, you cannot think. You think only when you become somebody. See? Observe your mind. If you are disturbed because of the children, you have become a father or a mother. If you have become disturbed because of your wife, you have become a husband. And thus, we are constantly becoming somebody or the other, and as a result, we are all the time disturbed. And we get tired of becoming this, becoming that. Then what do? We discard all these positions and go to sleep. That is why many people get good sleep when they come for satsang. And after the satsang is over, the whole audience was awakened. Why? During satsang they were sleeping. Now what happens when we sleep? When we sleep, we are Mr. Nobody. See? And when you are able to remain as nobody for 5, 6, 7 hours, after that, when you wake up, you are fresh, fully charged, creative, cool, happy. So the real spiritual practice is this. Give it a chance. Start with maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes. But don't do this while driving. You see this? I have nobody. Don't do that. When you belong to nobody, then alone you can be nobody. See? So if you are here working in the office or your laboratory, you are somebody, do your job. But Swamiji, you told us to practice nobody, I am practicing here. No, please. Now you are in front of your wife and she is complaining about the children. Look here, you know, our this Raju these days, you know, he is not studying and you sit there. Are you listening to me? I am nobody. No, that time listen to her. At least pretend. Because you have to play that role. So when you belong to nobody, now what is that time when you belong to nobody? When you get up early in the morning, you are not yet participating in the world. The whole night when you are sleeping, you are nobody. So continue that nobody status subsequently after you wake up for at least next 15-20 minutes. Try. Slowly, slowly, you will get a knack of it. How to remain as nobody? See? When you are nobody, you are everybody. Like, when the gold is not a particular ornament, it can be every ornament. In the same manner, when we practice this, spend time on this, just try. You take a position that you are a husband, sit down. A wife will start Tandava Nritya. See? Again, delete the husband. Now, you become the boss. Immediately, all the subordinates, like the flies, will eat your head. Delete. See? Then become a subordinate and sit. The boss will come and start hammering your head. Immediately, delete. See? You become a citizen. All the politicians will come with your chitta. Delete. Hindu you become. All the other religion people will come and eat you. Muslim you become. Other fellows will come and kill you. And now give it a chance. Remain as nobody. When we remain as nobody, you are in tune with the absolute divinity that you are. See, whatever may be the metabolic, physiological problems that we have, they all get sorted out in sleep. This strength of remaining as nobody is a common denominator. Every one of us is somebody or the other. The moment you become somebody, fighting will begin. And when we are nobody, there is nothing to fight with. See? And thus, slowly, slowly, you come to discover that really, when identified with the gross body, I become husband, wife, brother, father, sister, etc. Identified with the modifications of the mind, I become dreamer, a good or bad. Identified with their absence, I become a deep sleeper. But in fact, I am present in the waking, dream, deep sleep, and yet none of them touch me. This eternal common denominator, which is supporting the waking experiences, but not influenced by the waking experiences. Supporting the dream, but not becoming a dreamer. Supporting the deep sleep experience of nothingness, but never absent. That eternal, continuous, unbroken presence is the truth. Now the last leap in the thought process. At this stage, we are living as body, for the body, on everybody. When we start living, no more as a body, but start living through the body as consciousness, the quality of our life will change. See, like we function as a mind through the eyes and function as the vision. The same mind functions through the tongue as a tasting instrument. Mind is the same. Through the instrument it is separately functioning. But that doesn't mean the mind has become many, and therefore there is no mutual competition among the senses. Eyes never say to the tongue, you are lucky, nice mirch, masala, papad, chutney, I have to only see, I can't taste. So you become generous, okay, next chutney you take. See? Friends, the moment this kind of unhealthy competition and jealousy will disappear from our system, like mind supports all the senses, is never opposed to anything. In the same manner, when we start functioning as consciousness through the body, then the differences on account of the body, etc., will continue to exist. But because of the differences, there will not be differentiation. And that is called as Sab Sath Dengi. Like all the faculties are working together for a common cause of mutual coexistence. In the same manner, when we all work together in the spirit of togetherness, prosperity is bound. But if we start pulling like the Indian crabs, we will suffer in life. And when we thus live in a spirit of togetherness, what will happen? Your mind will remain undisturbed. Your mind will remain alert. Your mind will remain dynamic and yet cool. In such a mind, there is a natural inquiry about the divine thought. Like what we call, what is the clean mirror? Clean mirror is that where we see our reflection exactly as we are. In the same manner, pure mind is that which is able to reflect divinity in its entirety. Such a person becomes an instrument through which the divine works. So his every action is an expression of divine joy. His every word is an expression of the divine joy. His every breathing is an expression of joy. And don't we like anybody happy? When we like somebody is happy, we like that person. Imagine how much happiness it will be if you discover that happiness. Therefore, friends, living together means allowing that infinite divine bliss to express through every action, every word, every thought. If this is achieved, life is fulfilled. If this is not achieved, life is lived as a burden. And then such people have nothing but constant frustration. Ab ji ke kya karenge? Maro. Life is a celebration. Life is joy. And it can happen when we lead our life in its entirety. So, in our active life, in a spirit of togetherness. But that doesn't divorce us from our individual spiritual practice. Together we grow and attain bliss, and let that bliss express through us all the time. That is the meaning of living life in a spirit of togetherness. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.